Ted Sorensen was born in Lincoln, Nebraska, and graduated from Lincoln High School and then the University of Nebraska Lincoln with bachelor's and law degrees. He went on to serve as special counsel, advisor, and speechwriter for John F. Kennedy from 1953 until Kennedy's assassination in 1963.
Did you provide him with any advice going into that television debate with Richard Nixon?
Of course, the television debate with Richard Nixon was a turning point, not because there was a decisive winner, but simply because everyone assumed that Nixon, the veteran who had debated Khrushchev in Moscow, who had been vice president and world traveler for 8 years, would devastate this young senator from Massachusetts. And instead, Kennedy more than held his own. He sounded better, he looked better, he spoke better, and he hit home with facts that he wanted to drive home. He answered all the questions that the panel threw at him. That morning, we sat on the roof of his Chicago hotel. The debate was in Chicago. And I had a box full of cards that had been prepared by my deputy, who also came, I believe. And on each card was an issue or a question that might come up, either from the panel or from Mr. Nixon. What was Kennedy's position on that? What was Nixon's position on that? What were the two-party positions on that? What was the history, and so on? And on each card, as I would raise it, a little bit like the same routine we went through preparing for press conferences in the White House, JFK would say, "I'm all right on that one. Next." And I'd bring up another one. He'd say, "Oh, yes, by the way, would you?" And then he'd ask for some additional fact and ask my assistant to go dig up something, some other information. And next, and we sat there. And ultimately, he took a nap. He was so relaxed. And finally, I had to go in and wake him up from his nap and tell him it was time to go to the studio for the debate. I walked into his hotel room, and there he was, sound asleep. And he was lying there with these covered with cards. He'd gone to sleep looking at all the cards. So yes, he was prepared.
And you're telling me the most important advice you gave him was to wake up? What was there? Was there any coaching that you gave him, that other gave him, specifically
actually in the
for
car,
television?
Now that you mention it, in the car from the hotel to the studio, he had a sort of a TV advisor, a very nice man, but more for, who knows, what kind of background they have in the studio or shirt and tie to wear than anything else. Mm-hmm. But he was sitting in the back seat. I was up in the front seat. JFK himself was driving, as I recall. And in the back seat, this advisor began to say, "Well, now you should try to counter this with that. You know, it's like a prize fighter getting ready for a title bout." I mean, JFK was all tensed up, ready to go. He wasn't ready for, if you'll pardon my saying so, somewhat fatuous advice. He just shook it off, did not want to hear it. And I wasn't going to give him any advice at that stage. He didn't need it. He was ready for the title.